Can hear you.
How you doing?
Hi.
Ready?
Yeah. Oh my God. You look beautiful. You want a kiss?
Yeah.
You look amazing.
Thank you.
I love it.
Look at you.
Just a tux.
You look so handsome.
I love your dress.
Thank you. Can I fix your button here?
Sure. Yeah. Oh, yeah. Probably should fix. You look amazing.
Thank you. Do you like it?
Yeah.
You want to see the best part of it?
Sure. Oh, nice. Yeah, very fitting. I love it.
Yay.
Your hair looks great. I'm going to mess up your hair.
How are you feeling?
Good.
Yeah. Good? Good. You did it.
Yeah, we did.
Did you have fun in the morning?
Yeah, it's good. How was your morning?
Good. I'm nervous.
You're nervous? What's up?
There you go. I'm just nervous about this. Oh my God, I'm very worried. You have a little thing in your eye.
We are gathered here today to celebrate one of life's greatest moments as Devin and Jay, in their devotion, respect, and love for each other, choose to unite in holy union of marriage. Please be seated.
Do we hold hands or do we not?
You can, it's a cow. At this time, Devin and Jay would like to take a moment to remember those loved ones who could not be here with us in person, but are here with us in spirit. While these individuals are no longer with us, the memories that they have created, the lessons that they have taught, and the love felt for them in our hearts will be with us forever. At this time, may we please have a moment of silence to remember these very special people. Thank you. Now at this time, Devin and Jay would like to formally begin today's ceremony with an opening prayer. Let us pray. Bless this marriage, O God, as Devin and Jay begin their journey down the road of life together. We don't know what lies ahead, for the road turns and the road bends, but help them to make the best of whatever comes their way. Help them to hug each other often, talk and laugh a lot. Help them to continue to enjoy each other as they did when they first met. Help them to realize that nothing nor no one is perfect, and to look for the good in all things and in all people, including themselves. Help them to respect each other's likes and dislikes, opinions and beliefs, hopes and dreams and fears. Help them to learn from each other and to help each other grow mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. Help them to realize that there is design and purpose in their lives as in the world, and if they will hold on to each other, they will know that things have a way of working out for the good. Help them to create for their children a peaceful, stable home of love as a foundation on which they can build their lives. But most of all, dear God, help them to keep lit the torch of love that they now share in their hearts, so that by their loving example, they may pass on the light of that love to their children and to their children's children forever. Amen. Marriage is a coming together of two lives and a celebration of the love of two people, but it is more than that. The love that you feel for one another is the flowering of a seed that your mothers planted in your hearts many years ago. When you were first born, you were nothing but a bundle of diapers and tears, and your mothers lost sleep caring for you. Their love for you has brought them great happiness and great challenges. And their love did not diminish as they met these challenges. That is the great lesson that you can bring into this marriage. As you embrace one another in your love, so too do you embrace the families that have been brought together on this happy occasion. As a token of your gratitude for your families, I would like to ask that you please offer these symbols of eternal love, these roses, to your mothers. Devin and Jay, true marriage is more than joining the bonds of two persons. In its right relation, it's the uniting of two souls already attuned to each other. We are here to bear witness to the entry into the closer relationship of these beloved friends who are already one in spirit. You are now taking into your care and keeping the happiness of the one person in all the world whom you love best. You are adding to your life not only the affection of each other, but also the companionship and blessing of a deep trust as well. You are agreeing to share strength, responsibilities, and love. At the end of this ceremony, legally, you will be married, but you still must decide each and every day that stretches before you that you want to be married. Make such a decision and keep on making it, for the most important thing in life is to love and be loved. Love is the eternal force of life. It's the force that allows us to face fear and uncertainty with courage. Although you will be sharing one life, never forget that you are two separate people. Cherish and affirm your differences. Love each other. Keep your commitment to each other primary. Together you will laugh and cry. You'll be sick and well. You'll be happy and angry. Share and grow. And grow sometimes together and sometimes separately. It's important to remember that a good marriage must be created. In marriage, the little things are actually the big things. It's never being too old to hold hands. It's never going to sleep angry. It is standing together and facing the world. It's speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating your gratitude for each other in thoughtful ways. It's having the capacity to forgive and forget. And it's giving each other an atmosphere in which you each can grow. It's a common search for the good and the beautiful. It's not only marrying the right person, but it's being the right partner. At this time, I'd like to share a reading entitled Union by the author Robert Fulghum. You have known each other from the first glance of acquaintance to this point of commitment. At some point, you decided to marry. From that moment of yes to this moment of yes, indeed, you have been making commitments in an informal way. All those conversations that were held in a car or over a meal or during long walks, all those conversations that began with when we're married and continued with I will, you will, and we will. All those late night talks that included someday, somehow, and maybe. And all those promises that are unspoken matters of the heart. All these common things and more, those are the real process of a wedding. The symbolic vows that you're about to make are a way of saying to one another, you know all those things that we've promised and hoped and dreamed? Well, I meant it, every single word. So look at one another now and remember this moment in time. Before this moment, you've been many things to one another. Acquaintance, friend, companion, lover, dancing partner, even teacher, for you've learned much from one another these past few years. And shortly you shall say a few words which will take you across a threshold of life, and things between you will never quite be the same. For after today, you shall say to the world, this is my husband, and this is my wife. For our final reading, I'd like to share 1 Corinthians 13, verses 4 through 8. Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. Devin and Jay, I remind you that marriage is a precious gift, a lifelong dedication to love and a daily challenge to love one another more fully and more freely. With this understanding, the couple has decided to write their own vows for marriage with each other. At this time, Jay, please share your vows for marriage with Devin.
Dev, you look beautiful, and I can't believe today is the day where I get to call you my wife. How could I ever have a bad day when each one begins and ends next to you? I want you to know how privileged and honored I feel that despite all my imperfections, you still chose me. Becoming your husband is the greatest title I could ever ask for. Recently, I've been trying to figure out when I decided, I realized you were the one for me. Honestly, I can't point out an exact moment in time. I just always knew that you were the woman I wanted to spend the rest of my life with. It never required any additional thought or second guessing. You are without a doubt the most kind and beautiful soul I've ever met. You are the joy of my life. You are truly the only person I know that can light up a room just by walking in. When I look at you, I see more than just my wife. It's easy to see that you will be a beautiful mother to our children one day, and I can't wait to start a family with you. I promise to love you unconditionally. I promise to listen. I promise to grow with you. I promise to cherish you. I promise to always remember to treasure you. And I promise to always take the dogs out at night because you're scared of the bugs. You are the person I want to spend forever with. This is the happiest I've been in my entire life. I love you.
Nice job, Jay. Now, Devin, please share your vows for marriage with Jay.
Okay. Jay, wow. It is not often that I find myself unable to articulate my thoughts and feelings, but when I think of the past 10 years, there truly aren't any words to accurately reflect our journey. One thing I can say for sure is that my life would be utterly incomplete without you in it. It is extremely rare to find your soulmate at the age of 13, and even more rare to find someone who never leaves your side while you are growing and discovering your place in this world. Over the past 10 years, I've learned that love is constantly changing and is always a choice. The love I felt for you at 13, when you sent me flowers after our first date, is different from the love I felt at 15 when we experienced loss together for the first time. The love I felt at 18 when we learned how to navigate long distances is different from the love I felt at 22 when we moved across the country together. Through every new experience we face, I am amazed at how I am always finding new things to love about you. The woman you are marrying today and the man I am marrying today are not the same little girl and little boy who met in eighth grade. But those two kids would be so proud of the beautiful life that we've built together. As we stand up here today, I vow to never stop searching for new ways to love you. I promise to support you through any journey life takes us on and embark on every crazy adventure with you. I promise that when we are blessed to start a family, I will be the most dedicated mother and to provide our children with the best lives possible. I vow to always make you blueberry waffles and homemade pizzas on Friday nights. And lastly, I vow that when you are across the world, I will maintain the strong foundation of our home and have it waiting with open arms when you return. You are the light of my life, you are my calming hand, and you are the man I cannot wait to spend the remainder of my days with. Jay, I love you more than words can describe, and that love only continues to grow. Life has given us the gift of a decade together, and I cannot wait to spend the rest of our time as husband and wife. I love you.
That was absolutely beautiful. Jay, do you vow in the presence of God to love and cherish Devin? Do you promise to respect and support her dreams, to laugh with her, to trust and always believe in her, to shelter her when times are difficult, to grow with her, to have faith in your journey together through all the changes that will come, and to faithfully love her forever with all of your heart?
I do.
Devin, do you vow in the presence of God to love and cherish Jay? Do you promise to respect and support his dreams, to laugh with him, to trust and always believe in him, to shelter him when times are difficult, to grow with him, to have faith in your journey together through all the changes that will come, and to faithfully love him forever with all of your heart?
I do.
At this time, may I please have the rings? The circle is a natural symbol of eternity, as it has no beginning and no end. We place the ring on the left hand because it constitutes a direct path to the heart, a traditional metaphor for love and devotion. Its presence reminds us of the vows that we have made and their emotional seat of the heart. We ask that these rings that will forever grace the hands of Jay and Devin now be blessed. May these rings always belong to their hands and their love always belong in each other's hearts. May Devin and Jay wear these rings as a symbol of their unity. Jay, please take this ring. And as you place it on Devin's finger, please repeat these words, saying them after me.
With this ring, I promise to love and cherish you for all the days of my life.
Now, Devin, please take this ring. And as you place it on Jay's finger, please repeat these words, saying them after me.
With this ring, I promise to love and cherish you for all the days of my life.
Let these rings serve not as locks binding you together, but as keys unlocking the secrets of your hearts for each other to know, and thus bringing you closer together forever. As we come to the end of this ceremony, I ask that you both please remember this important marriage advice. Let your love be stronger than your anger. Learn the wisdom of compromise. It's far better to bend than it is to break. Look for the best in your beloved rather than the worst. Confide in your partner and ask for help when you need it. Remember that true friendship is the basis for any lasting relationship. Give your spouse the same courtesies and kindnesses that you bestow upon your friends, and say I love you every single day. As a collection of words, this ceremony will count for little, were it not for the love and the commitment that you have pledged here to one another. Your vows may have been spoken in minutes, but your promises to each other, those will last a lifetime. Having witnessed your vows for marriage with all who are assembled here and by the authority vested in me, it is with great joy that I announce that you are now husband and wife. Jay, you may now kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, family, friends, and guests, it is my honor to present to you for the first time as husband and wife, Mr. and Mrs. Jay and Devin Huron. seat, sit back, relax, and enjoy.
Someday, when I'm awfully low, when the world is cold, I will feel a glow just thinking of you and the way you look tonight. There is nothing for me but to love you and the way you look tonight. With each word, your tenderness grows, tearing my fear.
Let's give Chad a big round of applause, everybody. Let's go.
I hope the days come for him, the moments pass slow, and each road leads to where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking until you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth in your smile.
We have the last two really nervous people in the room up here right now. So, clap your hands, make some noise, make a lot of noise. Show them some love, everybody.
How's everybody doing? All right, everyone. So my name is Bradley, I'm Jay's younger brother, and I'm the best man. It's kind of a full circle moment for me for being the best man today, because when my parents first brought me home from the hospital, Jay asked if he could return me. So we've come a long way. First of all, Dev, give her a round of applause. She looks very beautiful tonight. Jay, thanks for coming. Congratulations, guys. Love you guys. All right, surprisingly, unlike all of my essays, Abby did not write this one. So, everyone knows the story of how Jay and Dev met, but no one's heard the younger brother's version. I was 9 years old when Jay and Dev started dating, and also about 5 inches shorter than Devin. I had slightly caught on to the fact that my parents and Abby knew Jay was texting someone named Devin for weeks, who I was told was a hockey teammate of Jay's, so I wouldn't make fun of him. Jay kept going to the movies with this Devin. He kept getting ice cream with this Devin. And then he even hit up Starbucks a few times with this Devin. One night I heard the doorbell ring while I was sitting in the kitchen table doing my homework. Put my head around the corner, and you wouldn't believe that Devin was a girl. And she was at the house to pick up Jay. For a date, I guess. But how gentlemanly are you, Dev, to come out of the car and come get him? So, good job. Guess she started wearing the pants early, I guess. Oh! And then, she said the most Devin thing I have ever heard and continued to hear for years after. In a loud voice, all I heard was, "Hi, Mrs. Haran." After they left, they shut the door, and my mom turned around to see me biting my tongue, and she said, "Don't say it." Dev, since then, you fit perfectly into the family. This day has been a long time coming, and I'm so proud to be a part of it, and thank you. The best part is you referred me as your brother-in-law, to which my response has been, continuously, not yet. Today you can officially call me that, and I'll stop being a smartass about it. For those of you who don't know, it goes Abby, Jay, then me. Being the youngest of three is pretty cool. I might get away with a lot more and have more fun and be a lot cooler than both of them. I also have two great role models in my life. For as long as I can remember, I wanted to be just like my big brother. I had front row seats to all your games. I watched you play Xbox, sacrifice being the goalie in knee hockey for you. And even though all the words to every Eminem song because of you. When I found out you were joining the Army, I felt sort of a comfort knowing that you were someone who many people look up to. I've always been proud to call you my brother. Now that we're older, I think our bond has gotten much stronger. I no longer feel like an annoying younger brother. I feel like a friend. I'm very happy to be actually invited to get lunch with you rather than mom telling you to take me with you. I'm forever grateful to have so many male role models in my life, and you're one of them. Every time I get into a tough position, I always think about what would Jay do and how would he handle it. I love having someone to share dark humor with and just talk over the phone, even though we're usually in different states. I didn't cry during the ceremony, so it's all good now. I cried getting up to the slide, so. Although we don't say it a lot, I love you, Jay. Did I really like you? And I'm really lucky to have such a big, great big brother. I can't really give you first-hand marriage advice, but what I can say is just wing it and it should work out. But in all seriousness, My hope for you two and your marriage is that you will know we will always love and support you guys. So happy for you two, and can't wait to see what the future brings. Cheers, everybody.
Abby Haller, and not only am I the groom's better-looking sibling, but I also have the privilege of being the most beautiful bride's matron of honor and best friend.
Can't hear it? Oh. Hello? Yes? Okay.
As many of you know, Jay and Dev started dating when they were 13 years old. Referring to Devin as Jay's girlfriend was funny for my family at first, because Jay barely talked until he was 12. Devin came into our crazy family and exceeded all expectations of what we could have hoped for Jay. Stop looking at me. For those of you that know me, I can be a little protective of my younger brothers. Maybe a little too much at times, but it is what it is. I'm not a fan of anyone who flirts with them, has been mean to them, or pushed them off the sidewalk in fifth grade on our way home from school. You know who I'm talking about. Jay, as protective as I am fully confident that Devin is the right person for you. I've had the privilege of witnessing your love story unfold from the very beginning, and I love watching you grow together. Although you two are younger than me, I've looked up to the both of you for many years. It's hard for me to say when Dev and I first became best friends. I was in high school when they were dating, and I had just gone through my first big breakup. That night, Dev brought me Rocky Road ice cream and told me she didn't even like him anyway. My brother's girlfriend was slowly turning into my best friend. Well, that time and during the next breakup and the next. And yeah, they've been together for a few of my relationships. But that is what I love so much about you two. It has taken me and most normal people a few failed attempts to find my forever person. You haven't even failed once. Not including Devin's 28 relationships in sixth grade. The two of you have stuck together through thick and thin, through high school and college, and even through different time zones. You've proven year after year and challenge after challenge that you will always be there for each other. Your relationship dynamic has always made me laugh. Jay is the quiet, reserved one. Devin is not. It's been really funny for Dev and I to be best friends, but for her to also be dating, marrying my brother. Sometimes she forgets that calling my brother so hot and or texting me that Jay's butt looks good in his jeans is not my favorite thing in the world. Either way, I am still so proud to call you my best friend. Throughout life, I believe we encounter many different types of friendships. Some teach us lessons, some help us grow, and if we're lucky enough, sometimes we encounter the type of friendship that sticks with you, no matter what city you live in or what phase of life you're in. This is the friendship I found in you, Dev. I could text you the smallest wins or hardest struggles of my day, and you are there. You're just as upset when my husband doesn't pick his clothes up off the floor, or just as happy when I tell you the pumpkin flavor's back at Dunkin'. You're always genuinely supportive and happy for those around you without any hesitation. I especially love our encouraging "we got this" text when we know damn well that we try to solve all our problems with a little dark humor, gaslighting, and iced coffee. It's a friendship I never take for granted and one that I am so thankful to Jay for. I always knew Dev was the one for Jay. Every year before I would go back to college after a long break, I would hang out with Jay in his room. We would stay up late talking about all sorts of things. I would tell him about college and parties, and we'd talk about our relationships, etc. I always looked forward to those nights. After he'd been dating Dev for a while, I asked him, "Do you think he would ever marry her?" Yes, he was way too young to be thinking about this. But I am his older sister, and it's my job to be nosy. After a few moments, he replied yes, and we just sat there quietly for a second. Then he quickly turned his head to me and said, "Do not tell her that." Now, as I reflect on those conversations and the years that have unfolded since, it's clear to me that Jay wasn't just casually considering the idea of marriage at the ripe age of 16. He was laying a foundation for a love that he knew would stand the test of time. The foundation the two of you have built together is only strengthened through the challenges you've faced the past few years. Through it all, the two of you prioritize home being a person. New Jersey, Oklahoma, Georgia, or wherever the future brings you, the two of you will always be home when you're together because of that strong foundation you have created. My one piece of advice for the two of you is that marriage is not always going to be 50-50. Some days marriage might look like 70-30, 60-40, and even 90-10, and that's okay. Jay, there will be days when you need Dev to pick things up when you cannot. Dev, there will be days where you'll need Jay to do the same. Marriage is about finding that delicate balance, but also about navigating the imbalance maturely, honestly, and with love. Now, this is normally the time in the speech where I would threaten my best friend's new husband. However, being that you're now married to my brother, it brings me great peace and comfort that I know he would never hurt you. I know his intentions and his kindness, and I know he could kick my ass if he wanted to anyway. While I'm still protective of my brothers, Dev, it's now time that I officially pass that on to you. It's your turn to yell at any girl who flirts with him. It's your turn to yell at anyone that's mean to him. And it's your turn to push kids off the sidewalk if they call him names. I put all of my trust and faith in knowing that you protect my little brother. Bradley and I would officially like to welcome you as our sister, even though you already have a key to the house. Now, if everyone could please raise their glass. In the famous words of Pitbull, life is not a waste of time, and time is not a waste of life, so let's stop wasting, get wasted, and have the time of our lives. Woo!
All right, let's give them both a big round of applause, everybody. All right, so folks, it's time to officially open up the bar. So the bar is now open.
One, two, three.
Thank you.
Kiss! Kiss one more time! Kiss!
Grand family.
Thank you. first to my last name. We'll just sound better together, and probably always will. Like a cup of coffee and a sunrise, Sunday drives and time to kill. What's the point of this on guitar if it ain't got no strings? Or pouring your heart into a song that you ain't gonna sing. It's a match made up in heaven, like good boys and beer and me, as long as you're right here. And me, as long as you're right here.
Sorry.
Hi!